Hello everyone. Today we will be looking at the 8-tree smart plug Matter version. So I reviewed the smart plug a few months ago. The Wi-Fi version works great. It's awesome. It's a great product, very affordable, and it was easy to install. But the only downside was you had to use their app to control the plug because it used Wi-Fi to control it, and you need their app to control it. Well, now they just released a Matter version. And for those who don't know, Matter is pretty much a protocol where big names such as Google, Amazon, Samsung, and Apple work together so that if you already have a hub in your house, such as a HomePod, Alexa, Smart Things, or Google Hub, you could just use their app to pair this plug up so you don't have to deal with another app. And it's really easy to set up. You still need one of those hubs, so just keep that in mind. And you do need Bluetooth and at least a 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi connection. So looking at this, as you can see, this is Alexa, this is Google, this is Smart Things, and this is Apple. So be sure you got the hub, the wireless network, and the Bluetooth capability. But this makes it a lot better because you don't have to worry about installing another app and controlling your device through this app. So for me, my smart home actually runs on something called Home Assistant, which is a open source smart home system. And I'm not going to be pairing it with any of these four systems. I'm going to be pairing it with Home Assistant, which is also really easy. So, I have all the hardware for it. Just be sure if you, for those of you who do use Home Assistant, you're pretty technical, so I'm pretty sure you already have the hardware to support it. And so let's go ahead and take a look at it. So the boxing looks the same like the Wi-Fi version, except there's a Matter print on the box now. So as you can see, very simple. Sorry, the white light is kind of drowning it out a little bit. But if you look here, this is the specification. So it's FCC certified, it's ETL certified as well. So it has been laboratory tested and certified. So you don't have to worry about that. This only uses 2.4 gigahertz only. So keep that in mind. Input voltage is 100 volts to 240, and max load is 1200 watts at 10 amps. So yeah, so that's some of the specification on the plug. And here, there's some stickers covering up, but it looks like it says Wi-Fi connection, app control, and you can set automations and stuff like that. So yeah, let's go ahead and take a quick look and see what is in the box. So this pack here is a 4-pack. So there's 4 plugs in here. And 8-tree did reach out to me to give me this to test, but I'm just providing you my opinion and everything. So this video will be released before I let 8-tree know about it. But as you can see, here are the plugs. So you get 4 of them in here, and it's their circular design, which in my previous video, I did complain a little bit about this design. Although it looks pretty cool, when putting it on an outlet, you can only fit one of these on an outlet, as opposed to the square style where you could actually put 2 smart plugs on one outlet. So if you plan to do 2 smart plugs, 1 outlet, you might want to look at a square version of it, but this one here is a circular version. So, you get 4 of these, as you can see. So 1, 2, I'll take them out here. 3, 4, let's make sure that we don't miss anything in the box. And then you have your instruction manual here. So yeah, so little introduction, specifications again, getting ready, how to set it up, and all that fun stuff here. Just some troubleshooting, just rolling it quickly so you guys could pause and look at anything if you wanna, if you're making a serious purchase and you wanna see what some of the instructions look like. FCC statements and so on. So yeah, so that's everything in the box. Pretty simple. So yeah, these are the plugs. Nothing nothing very, very special. So it's got the 8-tree logo on the top. You got the power plug on the side here. It's 3-prong. It has the information on the back, FCC, made in China, ETL again, and this is the QR code to scan. And yeah, so that is the plug here. So now let's go ahead and pair it up. Again, I'm using Home Assistant, so I'm gonna plug it into here. Just power one up. So I'm gonna move these aside to get it out of the way. And then now it's blinking. So there's a blue blinking light here, as you can see. So it's probably looking to pair up. So what I'm gonna do is, there's a QR code in the side here that says Matter. So you're gonna need to get your phone. So let me put my phone up on the screen here. Okay, so as you can see, here's my phone. So I'm going to go to the Home Assistant app, which is the app on the lower right corner here. So I already have it on. So I'm already on the settings page, but if you go to, you know, usually I have it on my overview here, and then you just hit the menu. Again, this is Home Assistant with the companion app. Then I go to settings, and then I go to devices and services, and then I hit add integration, and then I'm going to hit the very top where it says add Matter device. So now it's going to ask me, is your device already added to another Matter controller? Obviously it's not. So I'm going to hit no, it's new. And then it's going to ask to scan. As you can see, it's using my camera to scan. And then I scan the code. And then Home Assistant would like to add this accessory, so I'm going to add it to Home Assistant. All right. It looks like it's already set up. So I'm going to call this... since I have a lot of different types of smart plugs, I'm going to just call this... H3 smart plug 1, and then I'm going to hit continue, and then now, as you can see, it's added onto Home Assistant. So now it looks like it popped up on a page here under smart plug, and it looks like it sees the device. So there's the power on and off, and I can hear it turn on and off. So it looks like it's already communicating. As you can see, the blue light turns off. So I'm going to turn off my, let me turn off my lights here. And then you can see the blue light. See? That's how easy it is. And I'm using it in my Home Assistant. Home Assistant controls all of my smart things. So now I could control this on my Home Assistant using the same app. I don't have to deal with another app. And it's pretty quick. The latency is very, very fast, as you can see. You could rename it. So I'm going to rename this one here. Okay, so I just renamed it to 8-tree Smart Plug. So now it's called 8-tree Smart Plug. So now I could create automations where if I go back, and then I go to automations and scenes, create automation, create new automation. Let's do a trigger when time and location, when the sun is sunset. And then we could also make sure, you know, we could make sure that it's in a specific zone. So, you know, I could say when I am home, right? So now when it's sunset, and I'm home, add an action where the device, which is this plug, 8-tree smart plug, so there you see it, turns on. So that's how you create automations in Home Assistant. So when the sun sets and it needs to confirm that I'm home, then it will turn on the smart plug. And, you know, the smart plug could be on a lamp or any other devices to turn on while I'm home. And obviously, if I'm not home, it's not going to trigger it. So that's, you know, a quick automation on what you can do with these smart plugs. So it's pretty much straightforward. Really awesome that 8-tree released a product like this, because one of the biggest pet peeves is people having to deal with multiple apps for a different manufacturer. But since they're using Matter now, and it's pretty much an alliance between the big companies, it's easier to adopt a different manufacturer product into your smart home device or hub that you're currently using. So you don't have to run multiple hubs or multiple apps or anything like that. So yeah, that is the quick unboxing setup and a quick rundown of the automation setup of this plug. So really easy to set up, as you can see. So if you have any questions regarding it, just comment below. Let me know what's your favorite smart plug below too. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So if you have any questions, comment below. Like always, thank you for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out till next time.